Our objective is to write the search customer module now. That is, when the administrator clicks on this search, he should be able to get a form like this. And when he enters the email, an autocomplete suggestion list should appear here. And I'll fold it. And as soon as he hits this search, after necessary validations, like here this suggestion list is appearing, this is required, then when the search button is clicked, below it on the same form, customer details should appear, an edit button, name and phone, and order history, a button for issue invoice, and against each order an edit button should appear. This is the whole thing that we need in this module, and in future modules we shall be adding code for edit and issue invoice and edit here. But in the current module, our objective is to display the data for a customer and also to integrate an autocomplete. Let us start to write. You will get this book with the source code of this project, with the videos when you order. To store the information for the search view, we'll add a view model here. Right click, add class C search view model and click add. This is what we get. To this we shall add the properties. We can type email to search, then a required annotation, then a regular expression that it is an email, and then we can add for user, because the page will contain the user info also, and a collection of the orders also. So this is the view model that we'll need in this case. You must have seen that in case of MVC, things are pretty crystallized. There is a pattern. And after getting used to it, it becomes the simplest possible thing in web design, web development. Next, we have to add the view, but as usual, let us have a look at our menu search. So it has to be the index action inside search customer. Okay. Search customer is here and index is already there. Let us right click and add a view for it. And click add. This is what we get. We shall now add code to our index, and since a number of things are involved for this page, we shall attack the problem in steps. First of all, we shall show the search area where you can click the button for search and get the autocomplete to work. So this is our first objective. For this, we'll begin as usual. We'll have a search view model. Add the menu. then the form starts here. This form is for the search customer. It will contain the text box and the button, and whatever the user types in that text box, that will be submitted to the index action. The method will be get. So in this case we won't be writing two versions for catching the form data, just like we used post otherwise. This will be sent through a get request only. So we are going to probably have a parameter there and check whether it is null for a normal get request, or whether a query string parameter is there. Now why did I get this get here? The reason is that this is my search page. This customer is going to be searched from a number of places on the whole project. Supposing this is a page that showed your top 10 customers. The first column in that case was the customer name. We might turn it into hyperlink later on, so that when a user clicks this one, he posts a query string parameter to this search page. This will help us already display the details of the customer instead of the user requiring to click this search. So you can reach this page from a number of locations in your project, and for that we have put a get request. Then the same page has to be reached by the administrator when he types an actual email here and clicks search. So that the same code is there, we don't have to repeat code. Clicking on the search here will issue a get request. And when the get request is issued, the complete detail will appear in the same page. And when you come to this page from a different page by query string parameter, and in that case also we want the details to be already there. So that is why we have chosen this get here. If we had chosen post here, then we would have to write a different wire-up mechanism for handling the get requests that come from other pages of this project, and the intention of which is to ultimately show the details of the customer. So this design you can always keep in mind, because when you sell your projects to your customers, they'll definitely ask for a user-friendly interface, and in that case you have to always keep a provision for navigation from one page to another in a very smooth and systematic manner. You have to have these links everywhere so that the user can reach any page from anywhere. So the more navigation is possible, the better the design is from the perspective of the end user. Okay, filling this form, table TR email, text box for, then a validation message in case it's not an email, then a submit for the search. And I'll tell you, we have to attach an autocomplete to this text box. For this, we are writing in a JavaScript here in the scripts section. dollar hash email to search dot auto complete. We have passed two parameters. One is the min length 2. This means that autocomplete will switch on only after the user has typed at least 2 characters. Then what is this source? If you refer the jQuery documentation for the autocomplete, then source specifies the name of the action method or the receiver in case you are going through PHP and all. In our terminology, we'll say it's the action method which will return autocomplete suggestions, and jQuery will pass in a parameter to that autocomplete action method. We'll see in a moment what that parameter is. Just writing this one block completes the autocomplete story. The only thing you will need is to write this autocomplete action method with a parameter, the name of which is specified by the jQuery UI documentation. And from there you have to return a list of autocomplete suggestions. This is all you need in this case. Okay. So now our immediate job is to write the autocomplete action method inside the controller called invoice. We have chosen it this way. We could have put it inside any controller we like, but probably this page relates to something for an invoice, or so we have chosen to place this autocomplete action inside the invoice controller. Invoice controller is not there, so we'll add the invoice controller, and to that we'll add the autocomplete action. So we'll proceed right now. Right click, add controller, and it takes longer. So we have typed invoice controller and click add. Index is as usual. We reserve it for later use, but right now we have to add an action method called autocomplete. jQuery UI documentation says that to this autocomplete action, a string parameter called term is hard-coded, will be passed. So we have to take care of that string term, and the name is autocomplete. This term will come. So when the user has typed AB, then AB will be passed here. And when he types C, ABC will come here. So this is what we have to do. As soon as a command comes here for the term, we query our database dot where x goes to customer email dot starts with term and select only the customer email and convert it into array, and then convert the array into JSON and return that JSON back to the form where the autocomplete will begin to function. Let us now run it and see whether our autocomplete is working or not. Click to login, search. This form is there now. Nothing happens because it has been set for 2. Look, it starts working now. We typed AB and it has given all AB suggestions. So this is how this one is going to work for us, and we have seen that our autocomplete is wired correctly. In the next lecture, we'll begin to write code for the remaining of the contents of this page. Thanks, we'll close it right now.